Hear the music.
I thought it was great to use sounds and musical ideas that in the 80s were perceived as very serious. But now, in hindsight, when you play them back, they're actually very funny. That was the trick with this movie. We need music that is fun, but not funny. This is where it all began. This is one of the older synthesizers built somewhere in the 70s. This is actually a clone of the ARP 2600 with its sequencer. But this is actually the first thing that I did for Deadpool. And I needed this riff that I could use throughout the film to propel action, to propel motion. And that was really 100% Deadpool. And I came up with this riff that we hear through the whole score, but especially in Maximum Effort. So let me pull this thing up. So actually, this is the first thing you will hear in a film score.
Have you seen this man?
'89, time period where the digital synths came out, and these were great to create really nice lushy pads, and I used this for some of the emotional parts of Deadpool's theme. Now this one can be a very aggressive beast. It became very well known through Van Halen, who played the massive hit Jump on the synthesizer. The main riff for Deadpool was played with this instrument together with another instrument, and it's this riff. The Deadpool character has this very unique 80s revival electronic sound that has a super signature sound for Deadpool. Now, the other characters in the movie, since the X-Men characters have that noble quality to them, and because we already have a legacy of X-Men films, their music is very much in honor of the X-Men family. So a lot of horns, a lot of strings, and it has a noble, warm sound. That primarily was all done with the orchestra. Now we're not sitting behind a piece of vintage gear. This is all like new, but what is loaded inside this computer is very much vintage. And the instrument that I'm talking about is the Synclavier, which was, I think, made in the very late 70s, updated early 80s. The preset from this synthesizer as it came rolling out of the factory is this very well-known sound. And people identify it with Michael Jackson, and that's correct. Quincy Jones had one, and he used it on that album. So his main riff is... Another interesting year for Deadpool is 1983, when the DX5 came out. This was definitely the sound of Miami Vice. Jen Hammer used it a lot. And I used it for Deadpool to play a few of his riffs that come back over and over again in the score. In a film score in 2016. The combination of that with modern film scoring, with modern electronics, of course the orchestra that we needed on a couple of spots, really created that funky, arrogant, playful, violent music score for Deadpool.